brightly shine. In their first full day of orbit, Discovery Commander Steve Lindsay and his crewmates got their ship ready for its docking to the International Space Station. The crew completed the routine Flight Day 2 inspection of the thermal protection system of the space shuttle using the orbiter boom sensor system in the grip of the space shuttle's robotic arm to survey the reinforced carbon-carbon panels and the heat shield tiles on the starboard and port wings of the shuttle, as well as the nose cap, looking for any evidence of damage from debris, either from during ascent or while the shuttle has been on orbit. That information is in the hands of specialists at the Johnson Space Center, who will be studying it to see if there's any evidence of such damage or whether there's any need for any areas of the shuttle to have some later, more focused inspection. Along with that, the crew members also completed the checkout of the spacesuits that will be worn by astronauts Steve Bowen and Al Drew during two spacewalks next week as the shuttle crew members complete their assembly and maintenance work on the International Space Station. Crew has also completed the installation of a centerline camera in the orbiter docking system and extended the docking ring on the ODS to prepare it for its rendezvous. Both early in the day and late in the cruise day, Commander Steve Lindsay and pilot Eric Bow completed a firing of the shuttle's reaction control system jets to refine Discovery's approach to the International Space Station. The NC-2 burn and the NC-3 burns are putting Discovery on a precise trajectory designed to reach the International Space Station at 1:15 Central Time on Saturday afternoon.
Good burn, Discovery, no further trim required.
During the course of the day, early on, the crew also got a call from their additional crewmate, Mission Specialist Tim Kopra, original member of the STS-133 crew, who was unable to make the flight due to injuries suffered in a bicycle accident in January. He spent some time in the control room today and took a moment to talk to his friends on orbit.
Hey, Steve, Tim, I just wanted to tell you guys you all had an awesome launch, and we're all very proud of you down here.
Great to hear your voice, Tim. I wish you were here because I'd send you on the hunt for the overlay that I'm missing. But anyway, appreciate the good words. It was a great launch. Can't tell you how much we wish you were here with us as well.
Well, I'm sure you know that I feel the same way, but I definitely feel like I'm there in spirit, and I'm especially looking forward to seeing Steve and Al go out the door and do great work.
Kopra has been working with his crewmates since his injury to help prepare Steve Bowen, his replacement on orbit, to get ready for the spacewalks. And Kopra will also be on the console during the spacewalks to help direct his crewmates through the planned EVAs, which he helped to choreograph. On board the International Space Station today, a reboost of the station was completed using the ATV engines, the automated transfer vehicle, which docked to the International Space Station just a day before. And then later this morning, Commander Scott Kelly and his crew members opened the hatch to the ATV to get a look inside that European Space Agency supplied cargo vehicle. They will, over the course of the next 3 months, be emptying it of its cargo of food and other supplies and ultimately fill it with refuse and broken equipment for disposal when the ATV is undocked from the station and heads to a fiery demise over the Pacific Ocean in 95 days.